Hello everyone, how are you? Welcome to this tutorial, new tutorial, where I will talk with you about shoemaking tool. There are many different shoemaking tools that you as a beginners can use in your work. And I already made great tutorial about shoemaking minimum of shoemaking tools that you as a beginners can use in your work, the same tools that my students use in their work. But today in this tutorial, I want to show you another tool. It's not a traditional shoemaking tool, but with the time it became a shoemaking tool. Now I see it a lot in different tutorials where people explain how to make shoes. So this tool is a Dremel drill. When I started my blog about shoemaking, and then I started to make shoemaking tools back in days in 2013, I saw that beginners have difficulty to work with special shoemaking tools like carving knife. I teach how to work with this knife, and it's very important to learn how to use this knife, because without working with the shoemaking knife you can make shoes professionally, but it takes time to learn this skill. And I thought about some other tool that can help for beginners when they start making shoes to progress faster in their work. And we still working on we're still learning how, I still teach how to work with a knife to skive, because you know there are a lot of some tools like shaving, where you can kind of shave the edge of the leather, but it's good only for a few times, and with different leather types you can't use this tool, and it's very hard to sharpen it. And anyway, if you want to create shoes that will not look only beautiful on the pictures but will be comfortable made well, you should inquire this important skill, how to skive working with shoemaking knife. Okay, so until you will get these skills, you can use this tool, Dremel drill. And this one, it's very old tool that I got, I think, many years ago. I don't remember even when. The number of this Dremel drill tool is 300, and now there is a new version of this tool. I think it's 3000. So you can, if you want, you can find this new one. Okay, and there are a lot of additional things, to supplies to this Dremel drill, but we use in shoemaking only this thing, this kind of cylinder made from sandpaper. And it's very rough sandpaper. I think the grit is 50 or 80, so it take off a lot of material. And when we finish, when it become, when it doesn't work, you can change it for a new one that you can buy apart. Okay, so you can open here with special key this small screw and change and have a new one. It's very important, if you will use this tool, you need to have goggles and put some mask from dust. Okay, not use this mask now, we use a lot. There's special mask from dust, okay, because when you will work, you see, you will sand any surface and you will have a lot of dust in your room. So what is great about this tool? Actually, shoemakers have special sanding machine. It's a great, it's a big one that you can't put at your home, but you can use this and sand with this. They sand with this sanding machine very fast the bottom of the shoe. They have brushes on the same machine to polish the finished shoe, to sand the heels, to sand the shoe. So there are a lot of uses working with this special sanding machine. But you actually can buy this great, this big machine. If you can, you're lucky. But if you don't, even sure if the shoemaking is something is for you, so you can start with small things like this one, this Dremel tool, this Dremel drill. So what you can do working with this tool? We can do with this tool, for example, insoles. In my courses, I teach how to make insoles from different materials, from cardboards like Texon and Chanborg, from leather, vegetable tan leather. So when we construct insole from cardboard, we need to sand this area. You can sand it with a rasp, with a sandpaper, but with the Dremel, you can get faster results and you will save your time to shape this area very well. And I prefer, not prefer, I recommend to any beginners in shoemaking, make insoles by yourself, because it's very hard to find ready-made insole that will fit properly your shoe last. In the insoles, it's very important that this curve will match exactly the wedge of your shoe last bottom, and it's actually very hard to find already ready-made insoles that will match your shoe last, and that's why you should do it by yourself. And I already talked about it in one of my tutorials, so you can find the link to this tutorial below this video in the description. Okay, I will not repeat all benefits of making insoles by yourself. Now, if you have problems with skiving in the beginning, you should learn how to skive working with knife. But at the beginning, working with this tool, you can sand the edge of the of the shoe sole, because when we create shoe soles from vegetable tan leather, the thickness of the shoe sole that we must where we must use the back height of the animal, and this very thick leather, this is how it must be this is actually, it's very important to have this kind of vegetable tan leather for shoe soles, but it's thick. So if you want to create very elegant, beautiful shoes, we want to have thin edge. In the middle, it will stay thick, but in the edges, we will need to skive it. So if you still don't know how to skive working with knife, you can use this Dremel. It will take more time to sand the entire edge of the sole, and you will have a lot of dust, a lot of loud, but in the beginning you can use it and to have your first pair of shoes with beautiful shoe sole. Okay, also working with this tool, we can finish the edge of the shoe sole. It's very important to have very shiny, smooth edge, and in my courses I teach how to do it. Now with this Dremel drill, also you can sand the shoe bottom. Here you can sand it with rasp, but if you have difficulty with rasp, because maybe rasp with the working with rasp, you may not see where exactly you need to sand. Maybe it's possible. So you can work with Dremel drill, but before you will need to mark the line of the edge that you can't pass, because you will sand too much. And working with Dremel, slowly you can see it where you put the Dremel drill to sand it, to create this kind of sanded surface of the shoe bottom to attach here our shoe soles. It's very important to this step in shoemaking is very important for many reasons. One of them is to have beautiful shoes, because if you will not sand it, you will have here many bumps. Also to attach any type of shoe sole, to attach it better, you need to have scratched surface, and that's why we sand it. Okay, don't think that it's very easy to work with it. It's easier than skiving, but you also need to know how to work it to not ruin your work. Okay, so you need to work very precisely, and I teach my students how to work with Dremel drill. So just start working using this Dremel. Maybe you will see the difference between working with rasp and Dremel drill. Now, working with this tool, you can sand the shoe bottom to prepare it to the next step when we will attach shoe sole. Also, working with this tool, for example, you can sand heels from leather or from wood. Here, for example, in my course, moccasin course, we made here wooden heel and covered it with leather, so you can see how it looks without leather. So that's why now I will show you this heel from wood that I made. And a high heel, you see, what is important here is that in some places it will be difficult, for example, in this place where we attach the inner surface of the heel to the shoe bottom, it has kind of curve that maybe will be difficult to sand with the rasp. So you can sand with the Dremel drill this area in a part of the heel here, you can see it, to match the curves that we have here on the shoe. Okay, so working with Dremel drill, you can sand some places of your wooden heel. Of course, working with this Dremel drill, you still need to have some control on your work to not ruin your work. So when you will use this instrument, if you will want to use this instrument, you will need to pay attention where you sand and how you sand. Okay, and of course, don't forget, I repeat it again and again, about safe work. Please place goggles and mask during your work. It's very important, because some small piece of wood or leather can damage your eyes. Okay, so be very careful. And there are other uses of Dremel drill. For example, if you want to create shoes with heels, with wedge heel or platform from cork, you also can sand with Dremel drill to finish it faster, to work faster, not with rasp. With rasp, we still need to work in the beginning to create desirable shape, and then some small finishes we can do with the Dremel drill. Okay. Also, if you create heels from layers of leather, you also can sand the side surface of the heel with Dremel drill, okay? And it will be your final steps in the working on your heels, because first of all you need to work with rasp, okay? So this tool is additional tool in your work. You still will need to work with knife, with rasp, but this tool can help you, okay? And can you can progress faster working with this tool, okay? So I have also good post about this tool, and you can find a link to this post below the video in the description. So you're welcome to read this post too. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Here we have a lot of information about shoemaking for free, okay? And please click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you guys, thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. If you have questions, if I forgot something, you can ask me here, so comment below the video. And thank you, see you in the next video. Bye.